Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Perkenalkan, nama saya Weni Wulandari. Saya akan membuat video tugas dari Instagram yang berjudul The Boy and the King and People of the Trend. Suhaib bin Musinan reported that the messenger of Allah told their life a king, Yusuf bin was before you in Yemen, and he lived about 70 years before the birth of messenger of Allah, and he had a magician. As the magician grew old, he said to the king, "I have become old and my time is nearly over, so send me a boy whom I can teach magic." So he sent him a boy, Abdullah ibn Tamir, and the magician taught him a magic. On his way to the magician, the young man found a monk sitting there and listened to his talk and was impressed by it. It became his habit that on his way to the magician, he met the monk, said desert, so he was led in coming to the magician, who beat him because of the delay. The young boy made a complaint about it to the monk, so the monk said, "When you feel afraid of the magician, say, 'My people kept me busy.' And when you feel afraid of your family, say to them, 'The magician kept me busy.'" It once happened that there came a huge beast of prey, and it blocked the way of the people. The young boy said, "I shall find out today whether the magician or the monk is correct or in belief." He picked up a stone and said, "O Allah, if the teaching of the monk are dearer to you than the teaching of the magician, bring it to this animal so that the people will be able to move about freely." He threw that stone towards him and killed it, and the people began to move about or on the feet freely. The young man then came to that monk and informed him. The monk said, "My son, today you are superior to me. Your affairs have reached a stage where I find that you will soon be put to the test. And in that case, don't reveal my identity." The young man began to treat the blind and thus suffering from lepers, and began to cure people of all kinds of illness. There was a courtier of the king who had become blind, and he heard about the boy. He came and brought a number of gifts for the boy and said, "If you cure me, all these things collected together here will be yours." He said, "I myself do not cure anyone. It is Allah who cures. If you affirm faith in Allah, I shall also supplicate Allah to cure you." He affirmed his faith in Allah, and Allah cured him. He came to the king and sat by his side as he used to see before. The king said to him, "Who restored your eyesight?" He said, "My lord." The king then asked, "I did." The courtier said, "No, my lord, and your lord Allah." The king said, "Do you have another lord beside me?" He said, "Yes, your lord and my lord is Allah." Very fond, the king took hold of him and tortured him until he revealed the identity of boy. The young man was thus summoned, and the king said to him, "O boy, it has been conveyed to me that you have become so talented in your magic that you cure the blind and the suffering from lepers, and you do such and such thing." Thereupon he said, "I do not cure anyone. It is Allah who cures." The king took hold of him and began to torture him, so he revealed the identity of the monk. The monk was the summoned, and it was said to him, however, refused to do so. king ordered a saw to be broke and it was placed in the middle of his head and it fell upward. Then the carter of the king was broke and it was said to him, turn back from your religion, but he refused to do so. Then the same was done with him as well. Then the young boy was broke and it was said to him, turn back from your religion. He refused to do so and he was handed over to a group of his carter. He said to them, take him to such and such mountain, make him climb that mountain, and when you reach its top, ask him to give up his faith. But if he refuses to do so, throw him down the mountain. So they took him and made him climb the mountain. The boy prayed, O Allah, save me from them in any way you will. The mountain began to quake and they all fell down. The boy came walking back to the king. The king said to him, what has happened to your companion? He said, Allah has saved me from them. He again handed him to sum up his carters and said, take him and carry him away in a small boat. And when you reach the middle of the ocean, ask him to give up his religion. But if he does not give up his religion, throw him into the water. So they took him and the boy free. O Allah, save me from them and what they want to do. It was not long before the boat overturned and they were drowned, but he came walking back to the king. The king said to him, what has happened to your companion? He said, Allah has saved me from them. He also said to the king, you cannot kill me until I tell you how to do. He asked, what is that? The boy said, you shall gather people on a plain and hang me by the trunk of a tree. Then take an arrow from the quiver and say, in the name of Allah, the Lord of the worlds, then shoot an arrow. If you do that, you won't be able to kill me. So he did this, and placing an arrow in the boy, he shot in saying, Bismillah Rabbi, in the name of Allah, the Lord of the young boy, the arrow hit the boy in the temple, and the boy placed his hand over the arrow wound and died. The people proclaimed, we affirm our faith in the Lord of this young man. The carters came to the king and it was said to him, do you see what has happened? That which you fear has taken place, that their faith is in the Lord. So he ordered that dishes to be dug at the entrance to the road, and it was done, and fires were kindled in them. Then the king said, whoever abandons his religion, let him go, and whoever does not, throw him into the fire. The people carted that but did not refuse their faith from Allah until a woman came with her baby whom she was breastfeeding. She felt hesitant about jumping into the fire. The baby spoke to her, be patient, mother, for verily you are following the thread. According to some reports, about more than 12,000 people were burned into ashes. After that, the fire flared up so high that it spread out with the smoke the city and burned all those who were watching the fun of burning the Muslim. Only Yusuf bin Nawas, or the king, managed to run away and threw himself into the sea in order to save himself from the wreck of the fire, but he got drowned and died. It was about Nawas and his army that Allah revealed to his messenger in Surah Al-Burud, the
the reference is made to this incident. In a narration of Muhammad ibn Ishaq, it is reported that the village where the boy Abdullah ibn Tamir was buried had to be dug up for some important reason during the time of Sayyidina Umar era. There was a ring in his finger which had the inscription, "Allah is my Lord." The governor of Yemen informed Sayyidina Umar about this and he wrote back in reply, "Cover the body back, it was with his finger ring." Sekian video dari saya. Terima kasih. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.